Hey everybody, Drew here, and welcome back to the Pokemon Shield playthrough. This is episode 13. In the last episode, we finished going through Hammerlock City, picking up some items, getting a little bit of lore, and progressing in the story. So now we're going to go through Route 6 on our way to Stow On Side Town, or City, I don't know which it is, but we're going to go to Stow On Side and prepare for getting our next badge. And here's Team Yo. What a cute Silicobra. Just look at those adorable eyes. It's our duty as Team Yo to make sure that Silicobra get a nice peaceful sleep. Hello there. If I promise not to wake the Pokemon, will you let me through? Of course, it'd be our pleasure. Oh, hey, True. You're headed to Stow On Side, right? Oh, Team Yo. Don't suppose you'll let us through? Nah, you kids are way too loud. Can't be letting you through. And we're particularly not fond of the kids wearing challenge bands. With all your stomping around, Silicobra is sure to wake up. Right. What do you say, True? If we don't get past them, we won't be able to continue our gym challenge at Stow On Side. Alright, let's battle then. You two are way too noisy. You don't want to wake the Silicobra now, do you? I swear, kids these days. Well, we've got no choice. We have to send you packing. It's all for the sake of Silicobra. You would think with all the noise they make that they would be the ones that would attack the snake. I think I'll leave to see you, True. Keep up the pace. How long did he lose? True, you and both guys were brilliant together. See, BD really wiped the floor with me the last time we battled. And don't get me wrong, I can take a loss. Battling means you gotta lose sometimes. But he said that I was dragging Lee's good name through the mud, being so rubbish like I was. And I just can't get those words out of my head. If I'm weak, then people think Lee's weak too. But I don't want that. I can't let Lee get dragged down. He's the unbeatable champion. I'm gonna have to take some time figuring this out. See you around, True. Then I woke the snake up. Terrible. You're one of the gym challengers endorsed by Leon, aren't you? My name's Opal. If you want to know more, have a look at my lead card. I'll keep an eye on you, child. I want to see what you can do when you go all out. Here's the recovery. with the Ground type Pokemon. Here's a item. Three Ultra Balls. Ultra Ball is an ultra high performance Pokeball that provides a higher success rate for catching Pokemon than a Great Ball. Here's a fishing spot. Magikarp. So in this fishing spot you can catch Magikarp, Goldeen, and Dreadnought. Level 28. Magikarp will evolve to Gyarados with a rare candy if you have one. I believe we picked one up in the last episode, so if you haven't used it, you want a Gyarados. There you go, shortcut. For those familiar with Pokemon, Gyarados is pretty good. Here's a double battle. Let me see what two Pokemon I have. Okay. These guys out real quick. So if you traded for that Togepi in the last episode, Togetic right here on the left is the overall form of it. Thank you. Alright, so now with them beat, we can go up this alternative path and grab a couple items. Ability that seems a lot with one. Corvus Squad grew level 37, and then Corvus grew level 39. Dig. The user burrows into the ground and then attacks with the next turn. Here's a hidden item. You found two fossilized fish. Once I'm on reversal, but I'm okay. Pick up this light clay. Light clay is an item held by Pokemon. Protective moves like light screen and reflect will be effective longer. So that's good for the competitive scene. Most people in playthroughs don't use screens and things like that. We talked to this lady. Her name's Carolis, and she's researching fossils. Fossils in Galar are broken into top halves and bottom halves for some reason. Strangely, no matter which top and bottom you combine, they can be restored together. Perhaps within this mystery lies the key to understanding these combinable Pokemon. So the fossilized fish that we just found, actually in Shield you'll find fossilized fish, and in Sword you'll find fossilized dino. Those are two of four fossilized pieces, and you can mix and match the four sets, or the combinations to make four complete sets. bosses in this game are some pretty atrocious looking Pokemon. But, you know, part of the Pokedex. There's a hidden item, two rare bones. They don't evolve into each other, but they're like counterparts. This one looks like the thing from Fantastic Four. So a steel type Pokemon. So that's cool. And I'll take Steel Wing over the Shunts. Form of Peter Griffin. Here's a rare candy. Like I said before, if you wanted to go catch a magic carp in that little puddle below, give it a rare candy and have yourself a Gyarados. Provided you don't already have a water Pokemon on the team, or you just want to upgrade, Gyarados is a good pick. And the score screws level 38. The Randy is still in bug Pokemon. Steel type is pretty strong defensively. So if you want to have an anchor of sorts on your team, can't go wrong with a steel type. TM for Steel Wing, which Corviknight just learned. And here's your Torkoal. Alright, so now let's head on to Stow On Side. Call it SOS. One more trainer, Black and a Rose. Hope you guys feel level 39. But almost doesn't count. Tribute to Diglett. And here's Stow On Side. And there's Hop, trying to sneak up on us for a battle. Pokemon, and then you can check out the items in the city. So we can take these two fossils and put them with the other two we got and go to the research earth and actually make the fossil Pokemon. Or one of the sets of the fossil Pokemon. I believe there's, yep, a dust stone. A particular stone that can make certain species of Pokemon evolve. It holds shadows as dark as can be. These two guys are tree friendly. One sells bargain items. It's a crack pot, which you can use to get your own healthy guys. It's an evolution item. A particular teapot that can make certain species of Pokemon evolve. It may be cracked, but T4 can be delicious. I have black sludge. And then this guy on the left will buy random items from you at a overpriced bar. So say he wants a comment chart. If I have one, I can sell it to him and get $30,000. I think typically they sell in the market for like 10. So it's a good way to get some money. Moving along. Come down here. You can get that Pokeball. And this is an item. 3 rare bombs. Rocky helmet. An item to be held by a Pokemon. If the holder is hit, the attacker will also be damaged upon contact. Just hanging out, but not a dub trio. Here's a metal coat. An item to be held by a Pokemon. It's a special metallic film that can boost the power of steel type moves. And it can also be used to evolve Onix into Steelix. TM74, Venoshock. The user drenches the target in a special poisonous liquid. The move power is doubled if the target is poisonous. I think this guy about to commit suicide. Or something. Hey there, you happen to catch a lot of Maracas? How about trading you one for Impidimp? I believe we have a Maracas. Oh, we do. So let's get our trade on. Impidimp is a dark and fairy type Pokemon. Pretty good. Another good Pokemon to want to meet the rest of the team. Good coverage. Gonna fight hot. true. I'm still not too sure what I should do about all that stuff I told you before. About me being weak and dragging down Lee's good name and all, yeah. But the only thing I can do is get stronger, right? So I'm gonna try all kinds of different things against you to see what works. Then let's do it. I bet an all-out battle with my true rival will help me get my head on straight. Bolton and Inteleon grew to level 40. Snipe! Corviknight grew level 39. That defense side is pretty good. Toxel evolves at level 30. So I should try and do it one more level. Good for him. Tried switching my team members in and out to max out their potential in every matchup. We just couldn't get it done together somehow. Maybe that's why I'm so weak. But Lee really is the greatest trainer, and I don't want people to be laughing at him all because his little brother's rubbish. It's not enough. I've got to try harder and harder till no one's laughing. I'm off, mate. Off to find the kind of Pokemon that I can really drill the strength out of. This is the second time this elderly woman has snuck up on us. Gym challengers should battle for the sake of their own Pokemon. Why worry about saving the champion's name? We all know he's unbeatable. Anyway, here's something for letting me watch your battle. Now on you go, child. You're headed to SOS Gym next, right? The gym challenge is about having fun. So two things I want to call out. One, in Shield, the gym is a Ghost type, and in Sword, it's a Fighting type. So if you're following along and you're playing Sword, instead of getting Alistar's lead card, you'll get B's lead card. Also, the guy sitting on the roof that does the trade in Sword, he'll offer Patina instead of Impidant, which is a psychic fairy type. And here's the gem. If we go this way, we got this for a little bit. Item. This is a match revive. Those are always super useful. And for whatever reason, you cannot buy them. And here's a big mural. We'll come revisit that in another episode. But for now, everyone. Thanks for watching. Please feel free to like, subscribe, share, comment below. And in the next episode, we'll take on the SOS gym mission. Till then, I'm True. Peace out.